ride, just keep it 100.
Yeah.
Should never be hard to be real when you keep it 100.
If I kiss you and hug you, I love you, that mean you better
keep it 100.
What's going on, y'all? Man, you tuning in to No Cap Table Talk, episode 4. Don't you like, comment, subscribe. So, reminder for you, so you'll pop up, you know what I'm saying? Today we got a couple things we're going to talk to y'all about. Well, actually, we got like 2 topics, maybe 3. But, yeah.
Shit, you know it's your host, CEO Sim.
It's your boy, Willie D.
And it's your boy, OG Moop.
Shit, and I think the first thing we wanted to talk, kind of touch on was the Big U and Quando Rondo kind of situation. It ain't really no situation. We ain't trying to put no crips against each other, no bullshit or nothing like that. We just, you know what I mean, talk at everything at the table like how we do normal everything else. But what y'all think about the situation? Y'all think that, do y'all think that he was trying to check in, or do y'all think he was trying to do what he said on some charity shit? Because he said he was trying to check, he said he was trying to hit him, because nobody fucking with him since after this Von shit. Ain't no real resources fucking with him.
So he trying to
give back to the kids and trying to like get his name back clean so it won't be so fucked up. So he hit you to see if he can help him do something, because he know you do a lot in the community and shit like that. And he just trying to, he figured like, well, if Cuz one of the big homies then, and he got some shit going on, I know he'll let me get in rather than this white man who ain't giving me no turn because of the last shit that happened. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So do you think it was that, or do you think he checked in because he needed help from the Von situation?
Man, Von situation. But either way, I mean, either way it go, I feel like, why check in now? Why wait till something happened to reach out?
But like I said, though, he might have been, he's saying that all the white people, basically he's saying the white people is blackballing
him. Why wait till the white people will throw you out the picture to come check in with somebody that you could have checked in with before? So just in case if something like this was to happen, that'd be your back.
No, I'm not. But he said that he's not even trying to check in. He just trying to basically, if you own a company and I know your company, I can give back to your company and shit that you do, but these corporate motherfuckers ain't let me do that, even if I'm trying, because I got the money to do it, they ain't let me do it, but I know you another black man. That's why I came to you, because you another black man, and plus, you 60s. So, maybe that's why. I don't think he's saying it as in a check-in stage. I get what you saying, though, like, why check in now if you ain't never spread no love before? But why would I have to spread love before when I got all these other connects?
Don't come to me when you need a connect then. If that's the case then, because when the opportunity was there for him to introduce himself, not even just, okay, take the checking in out, introduce yourself. You never introduced yourself before, but now everybody throwing you curves and turns, you see an opportunity over here. And you already knew it was an opportunity before it even happened. You knew it was an opportunity over here.
Right.
But you wait till it's curves and turns to come to jump on the opportunity. But
I understand that. See, I thought he had to, he wanted him to check in because he went to Cali. So
he was just trying to give back. He was just trying to do something to clean his name up because his name dirty right now. Yeah. Don't nobody want to fuck with him or none of that.
See, he probably went into that. He probably went helping the community and doing all that shit.
That's why.
And now he got a reason to do it.
That's
probably why.
And I get what you're saying on the strength of shit. If niggas ain't fuck with me before, it ain't no reason to fuck with me. I feel that on 100%. But then again, Big U did say his son and Quando know each other. So he done ran into Quando before. Quando done, they know each other.
Yeah.
He just ain't checked into the hood. They done seen each other for a few minutes. But
Quando check in with everybody else around him. Don't go to the.
But he said they had words before, but he ain't checked in. Like he ain't checked in how he supposed to. But he said
they probably had words shit, like on some
music shit or whatever.
Yeah, but you never came here on some some real, like, check-in, you just come to talk a little business, but it's not even nothing pertaining to me. It's probably to somebody pertaining to somebody else, but you got to go through me to do this feature with this artist.
Right.
You didn't come to me on some...
I
got to
go through him.
Because, what if he's the manager for that artist?
Yeah, because Biggie, yeah. He in the music world too.
Yeah, if
he manager. Said he ain't doing but that really no more, but yeah.
But if the nigga just the 60 and
but,
and he ain't the manager or nothing, he ain't got to go through him, right?
Another question I got is, if I ain't coming to the city, why should I check in? Like, you get what, like, if yeah. I, because like he said, he only trying to basically do something to clean his name up, but he will have to come to the city then.
Yeah.
But what I'm saying, if I ain't never had to come there before and need to check in, then why would I not? Or whatever. Like, I mean, like, if, because if I'm still in Georgia and you in Toledo and I'm not coming down here for nothing, I'm not steady down here, why would I check in with you? That's what I'm saying. Do you feel like that's a relevancy? If he have to still check in, if he not even coming to the city?
Nah, you not, for what then?
But that's what I'm saying by that conversation that they could have had just on some music shit or whatever. He
but your intentions was,
I think
but your intentions was to come out of here, was to come out here. So you checking on me before you came out here. That's what Wanda was doing. I'm going to go out there. I'm going to put this little thing together. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to call Big Homie now and see what's going on, see if he can help me with this shit. But why didn't he call me when you came out here and did a sold out show? It was like, hey, Big Homie, you know, I'm in town for the weekend. Why don't you go ahead and come down and show some love? You got your little artist coming on, bless the stage with me. You feel me?
I feel that.
I feel that.
Why wait till your nigga done killed the nigga? But y'all claim what I claim, and now you coming to me like, hey, ain't nobody else fuck with me, you my only option.
But maybe the circumstances is different. Like, if I got a show in the city, if I got a show in your city or whatever, and I might know you, like he's, it ain't like these are two random niggas, like I ain't never know, I don't know who this little nigga Quando is. So he know of him. So if I done talked to you before or whatever, and I come to your city and I got a show, and I might not have checked in with you, why you don't come to my show and holler at me? I mean, I understand it work both ways. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yo.
But see, he the big homie, so he ain't about to
pop
up at your
show.
You a small fry. Why should I gotta come and ask you what's going
but
on?
Think,
motherfucker, you in my city
but think about
with
it.
60 niggas, and you talk about some U60 crib.
But like Big U was saying, he probably at the same time was nervous to call out to, you know, like, shit, that's Big U. He might be like, man, I'm about to come. I got time to come to your little ass show.
Yeah.
He probably was nervous too, but, you know, niggas ain't going to speak on that. These niggas try to
but,
stay real.
But why wait till, my thing is, why wait till now? Why you couldn't do all this shit before it was, why you wait till the killing start? When the beef was just before the killing, when it was back before beef, and you could have reached out then. These niggas when they clicked up with a whole nother state.
But,
a whole different group of niggas. But we on the same team, and you ain't coming to click up with us.
The thing that's funny to me is the Von shit didn't happen in Cali. It happened in Atlanta. So that's kind of weird to,
that's
you keep saying, Big U keep saying like, oh, he ain't check in and check. But it's like, to be honest, this is what's killing me. To be honest, if I called your phone or your phone to even do anything, even not to check in, and even if you felt some type of way, I ain't go to the media first and was like, I tried to hit Big U and he ain't get in touch with me. You the one that got on the internet like, I ain't fucking with cuz. It's too late now, so now I gotta, now he had to get on the internet and explain himself like, well, I tried to hit Big Homie up because he supposed to be Big Homie and he supposed to, I'm thinking that he gonna look out for and do this and that.
Now,
but then he get on some internet shit and get, yeah, but I don't know if bro was just really trying to like check in, or if he just felt like,
all right,
maybe another black man was just gonna help me type shit.
So let's put it like this. Let's say, cause you an artist, right?
Right, right.
Boom. Let's say you claim You claim 60s too.
What?
Right. And you went to it with some Milwaukee niggas.
Right.
Boom. One of your homies killed a Milwaukee nigga, right? But you've been going out to Cali a couple times. You done went through the 60s hood. But you never...
Never checked in.
You never stopped. And,
right.
Let's take the checking in now. You never stopped and chopped it up with
in
nobody.
In the hood, I know. Okay.
You never stopped to...
Okay.
You've been to the home turf plenty of times. You went by Nipsey's.
But have I had a conversation with Nip? See, that's where the line kind of fall at with a young nigga. I mean, not even just saying me, but I'm just saying if a young nigga feel like... Like,
no, you going to pay your homage. You paying respect to Nip. You going out to the Nip Memorial thing. You out there taking pictures of the Nip Memorial and everything.
Okay,
you feel
right,
me?
Right. You're supposed to get up with the Crips then.
Yeah, you doing all that. You definitely got to get up with the Crips. You definitely got to get up with the Crips. You do anything as such.
Especially if
you're nigga,
from
because
Nip and
you
from
if you paying any homage to Nip, why not go pay respect to your homies? Right?
Yeah, he right. He was wrong for that. But, Big U... How he handled that wrong outfit.
That's what I'm saying.
By being a big homie.
That's what I'm saying. Only because of the simple fact why we never knew that Quando ain't check in until he killed King Von. Because he been ain't checked in.
Yeah.
He been moving around.
The same reason why we didn't know that Pop Smoke never checked in.
No, what I'm saying, Pop Smoke dead though. So that's kind of.
Yeah, but when he was living though, he never checked in with nobody.
But like you said, he ain't no 60, so it really kind of ain't really like relevant. Yeah. He should have checked in with somebody in that city no matter what. But being in the 60s, it's like, I mean, I don't know, like if I ain't never checked in before or nothing like that.
Okay,
like,
so basically you said checking in should only go towards gang members, right?
Yeah, because think about this. If I'm even okay, because we don't even know. I mean, I don't know if Quando play that role or what, but some niggas just be playing that gang role. If niggas playing that gang role or whatever, and I come to Atlanta,
I don't think he ain't playing.
But if I come to Atlanta or I'm on a tour or whatever, and I come to Atlanta and I go to the Lexus Arena or whatever, the big arena. If I come to the arena and I'm only going to the arena, I ain't going to the club. I'm going to an arena, or I might go to somewhere on the other side of town. And I'm going for a couple hours, 30 minutes or something, and I'm shooting back out. I might not even have time to check in. It ain't even no point because I'm thinking like, I got my shooter right here with me. I got bro,
yeah,
50 got the spot.
What was your question you said?
He said, only gang members should check in.
I feel like no, everybody should check in. And then on that, because checking in ain't just because you in a gang and some niggas out, you feel me?
Yeah. It's just keeping yourself safe.
It might be like, I can tell you all, don't go over here on this side of town because...
Mm-hmm.
They licking niggas mm-hmm. right now, and
yeah.
you definitely,
nigga,
you definitely the type of target.
I guarantee when Chance the Rapper go to LA, he check in with somebody.
Yeah.
If it ain't Snoop, Big Wack,
yeah.
Somebody he check. Chance the Rapper ain't game to feel it, but he know where how to move. But I can't really say, bro, because like I said, shit get fucked up with the internet. Because we all wouldn't even be talking about it at the table if it had never got to the internet. If it had stayed in the hood with 60s or whatever,
yeah.
We wouldn't even know about it. Quando would have just felt that draft like, damn, I gotta move different now. Because Big Homie ain't even fucking with me.
Right.
But now all of us got the opinion on how it should have went and how it could have went because it came to the internet. Like...
I mean, I don't feel like Big U was wrong at all, though. I mean, he put it on the table, so I'm going to keep it real.
See, he put it on the table. I understand that. But what he got to understand, too, is he a street nigga. He ain't used to this internet shit. Charlamagne live and breathe and deep this internet shit. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's why he pulled that question up out his ass. It wasn't nobody else but Charlamagne. Charlamagne be knowing what the fuck he doing. He get to pulling that question out of his ass, and then Charlamagne bring it more to light.
Yeah.
And then that's when he said, well, yeah, Quando Rondo was just the one who, yeah, man, I can't even. So, he got to kind of, Big Homie just got to kind of know how to play it, because in the sense of being a Big Homie, that was kind of unforward, I think. I mean, you know what I mean? I ain't got no disrespect to the 60s or nothing, but I just felt like that should have stayed in between the circle. And if that's the case, then that's the case. But niggas ain't never trying to check him for not checking in before. Like how niggas was checking Soulja Boy and Chris Brown. You get what I'm saying? Like that should be internet shit.
Yeah, but okay, but that's different. That's different though. Cause you know Soulja Boy he didn't come into the game.
But why Chris Brown they check Chris Brown for not checking in?
No, way back when Chris Brown was a younger, way
because
way
they didn't back, come way in back. On
because that. Because he from Virginia, but he Piru blood or something. Like he from Cali, just like Soulja Boy from Alabama, but he blood from Cali or some shit like that.
But see, that's different though, because it's like when you either come in the game as you come in industry as a gang member or you don't. It ain't like I was saying on the documentary, how these new niggas get this money, get certain amount of money. And then next thing you know, nigga, I'm a gang banger now, I'm a Crip now, I'm a Blood now. You know what I'm saying? So that was a different story on their end because shit, nigga, you came in here cranking that song, singing, kiss me through the phone. Yeah. Now you talking about some, what up, Blood?
Yeah, but that I only say that to go back to what Bro was saying, as everybody got to check in because they was only checking in because they was famous. Niggas was only checking them niggas because they was famous and had rags and shit. Hold on, wait, y'all niggas ain't Blood for real? What's going on?
They weren't checking in, they was checking them niggas. Fuck.
Yeah, because niggas was on some fraud shit. Yeah. You feel me? Niggas like, hold on, wait. And then Chris Brown got the moving right. Soulja, he move how he move, you know what I mean? But
big Soulja.
But I don't know, like, I don't know.
I'll knock Soulja Boy ass up, boy. Yeah. Come on,
bro. Knock Soulja Boy out.
What?
That nigga. Soulja Boy is shooting. You know?
Man. I can never see him shooting a gun. He probably can't even caught that bitch back. He's so damn little.
What that nigga say? I took his mask off and I shot him again.
So shit, since we already damn near went on the checking in subject, do we think that's relevant? Let's fall off into this rapper death small little segment. Well, it probably ain't even gonna be small. So it probably go back to the checking in, but not even checking in. On the Nip situation, how y'all think that shit went?
As far as what?
Like, because that don't involve no checking in. He from the hood. He on shit.
Sad to say, I feel less on the Nip situation. Him and his mans, they was lacking. They was lacking because I can't have that much money be. I don't care if I'm in my hood or wherever I'm at. I can't have that much money and be a 60, a gang member, and live this life.
Yeah, but then you also got to think, too, though. Everybody was convicted. Felons in the area. It was supposed to be one of them areas where you...
Felony that you can't carry a gun no more?
Yeah, you got to think. They on that three-strike rule, too, though. You feel me? If I'm trying to get everybody elevated to be on a straight path, why even have a piece of negativity
But yeah, you are rolling 60. That's a piece of negativity gonna stick with you the whole way. So if the Bloods come shoot this motherfucker up while we singing shirts at this motherfucking store.
Yeah, but you know, but in their and they mind frame and in their tax bracket, that shit ain't finna happen at all. Period. That's not finna happen.
I don't see why, because a street nigga, no.
Yeah.
I don't care how much money you got.
Yeah. It's the difference between me being in the street nigga, but still being the street nigga, and me having money and moving smart.
And didn't they say he knew that nigga over there?
Yeah. So it's not like
And then he checking his nigga, because you were snitching, telling this nigga get the fuck from around here.
But it's on papers that he was doing, a snitch, though.
Yeah, you right, but you doing some gangster nigga shit.
That's what you feel.
And you ain't got no pistol on you, and don't nobody around you got no pistol. Can't be doing that.
What you think, Mook?
Man, that's the people least suspect. At least suspect for him not to have no pistol.
Man.
Somebody was supposed to have a pistol, but in his mind frame and how he was moving, that would have brought that negativity with it. If I got a nigga carry a gun, that means we gotta watch our backs. We not watching our backs no more. We out of that stage of life. Yeah, but you out of that stage of life though.
How? You think you can just walk in any, go to any city in any blood neighborhood and nigga ain't gonna speak on you?
Yeah.
Okay, you still in that life, so he gonna need some shit around him.
But see, I ain't
gonna count. These young niggas nowadays, they wanna. Yeah, these young niggas sitting back and probably like, that nigga come around here, I tell that nigga, get the fuck from around.
I get you.
Just to get some fame type shit.
I get you 100%. But yeah. I still don't. I think to be, I'm gonna be 100. No, and we not wishing that. God willing, God blessing. But I feel like you will end up going like Nipsey, only because he not gonna move with no strap. He ain't gonna move with, because he gonna feel like, I'ma die with my respect. If a nigga ain't respect me, they gonna have to come back, the homies gonna have to, you feel
so
me, do what they supposed to do.
Be all this deep, big, you be deep.
Yeah.
You be deep.
But
you don't think none of these niggas got
that's
strap.
That's a different.
But look, when have we ever seen you with a strap?
Yeah.
That
nigga use these.
But see, he said in the documentary, he was like, we was in the guns now after his cousin got shot and he moved back. He said, we was in the guns now.
Yeah, but that's before he did the 57 years.
You right.
Niggas out here.
Niggas bring up OB just because they ain't fame. But they know how these streets go, man. I think they be having pistols, but...
But when you're in a different tax bracket of money, bro, you know...
That's when you
ain't
supposed to keep a gun.
What? Why is you even in the hood is the question. When you got a different type of money, why is you even in the hood? That's my thing, though.
They use that as business, as a place of business.
That's different. He never left from over there. He, like they, like you said, the nigga lived over there. Nothing changed. The only thing changed was he elevated. So now I ain't on the block. I'm not hanging with the homies. Yeah, I got the homies around, but I got the homies around that I'm trying to help uplift because I'm on that level where I ain't worrying about looking over my shoulder while I'm riding down the street. Nigga, the nigga riding down Slossin' by himself with a $1 million with a jewelry on and a Maybach at a red light, just chilling. If I'm too much worried about that, where my motherfucker put up on the shoe?
Nigga doing that, nigga ain't worried.
A nigga ain't worried, period.
Nigga ain't worried. Niggas gonna go out how they
right.
If you don't feel like you can be in your city,
but he know what come with that shit.
Niggas know.
Every nigga know that. I don't give a fuck who you is. If you ride down the street with ice on and a motherfucking ice ass whip,
yeah,
you know you get that shit.
You know what come with it, but you are so, your mind so. I'm so good in life right now. Niggas ain't even worried about robbing me.
Think about how long a nigga moving militant. Think about how long, you feel me, a nigga been moving militant. You been moving the same way for so long,
yeah.
And ain't nothing happened, and you still moving this way.
You like, I'm good.
You
so
like,
I'm with 15.
So basically, you got comfortable.
Hell yeah. No cap. Everybody.
I ain't gonna lie.
At a certain stage.
I get $1 million. I'm comfortable too. I can walk anywhere I want to. I go any fucking wherever. That's how I'm gonna feel. But if now, if I'm at that stage to where I know, you know what I'm saying, it's some consequences or some things I've done in the past that hold some weight, nigga, I'm going, then that's when you check in, like, hey, look, what's up, Dirk? I'm coming to Chicago for the weekend, you feel me? Just let me know, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm going to be in your city, nigga, I ain't finna be moving no crazy, but
why
I'm just letting
you
know.
Why you gonna call Chance? Why you gonna call Dirt?
Why would I call Chance? Chance is a stripper.
Chance gonna be like, call Dirk.
Chance gonna be like, so who we donate money to? No, I'm not coming. Dirt. I'm coming to collect, not
call
spend.
Dirt.
So, yeah. I don't know, man.
I love Nip. Like, I was on the Nip. It seemed like I got on the Nip right before he died.
That's like a nigga telling DJ Khaled to check in.
No cap.
I bet he do though. He get with some rapper or somebody.
And nice.
That's checking in. That's all you gotta do to check in. Is get up with somebody that's from there. So you can know. Cause they know what's going on in their city.
It ain't. Yeah. But it really ain't checking in if you already know a nigga coming.
So.
Sometimes that dodo nigga come, you call him like I am coming and let him know.
Yeah, hey y'all. But I'm flying DJ in.
Kelly going, you know he coming.
Yeah.
You know he coming. Did you know he coming?
It ain't no, kind of just popped up on us. It's, hey, Sim.
But
Sim,
you don't
what time you say Kelly was coming again? Yeah.
But you
all right, think we got to make sure this motherfucker tip-top perfect shape when he comes to this bitch, nigga, it's going to be the truth.
Hell yeah.
Since before we leave off on Nip, I think
we're talking about the dead rapper still.
Yeah. I'm just saying before we get off of Nip, I think he died like March 29th, if I'm not mistaken, some shit like that. I promise y'all, this no cap. I'm gonna put it in the motherfucking. Y'all gonna see this shit. I'm showing him at the table. Look what that say. March 27th. 2019. I was sending Nip my music just to let him know, like, I fuck with you, bro. Like, man, real, man. Like, real smoke. No cap. That the date on there, March 27, 2019. Man. I was already on to him. I was already like, man, something about that nigga. I love about that nigga. Like, I was already into it. When he died, that shit crushed me, nigga. Shit was superstitious to me, bro.
I didn't know the nigga was a rapper.
I promise you.
I knew him from doing movies.
Mm.
When he did the movie with Billy the Kid and the nigga from Holiday Heart.
That's funny. I know what you're talking about when they was brothers and shit.
They found out it was brothers in prison and they were about to kill each other type shit. Yeah. That's where I knew Nip from. I ain't know niggas no rapper at all. But then I saw his song. But then, like, I want to say shortly after that, that's when I started hitting lit up his rap. And I was like, oh, yeah.
Man, one of my big homies turned me on the Nip. And they turned me on the Nip. And, matter of fact, no, that was East and Starlito. But I don't even remember how I got turned on the Nip. But like I said, I was just so turned on to him. I'm like, man,
damn.
I don't give a fuck if he don't message me back, nigga. I gotta let this nigga know, nigga, I fuck with you, bro. And I swear to God, too, it might have been 3-4 days after that, but It was crazy, bro. Like,
no, he died on the Saturday. Bro.
Man, that shit crazy, man. R.I.P. Nip, bro.
R.I.P. Nip. I got turned on a Nip.
C.I.P.
I think he was talking to, somebody was playing this shit and he was talking some all the way crip shit, dude.
Yeah.
And I'm like,
through the map.
Fuck is this?
And then when the nigga got on 2K, and, I mean, this before he died, when he got on there with the last time that I checked, then they did him and YG perform that at the Staples Center.
Yeah.
Man, I'm on all this shit, nigga. I'm like, damn, I'm watching this progress. Man, that shit crazy, bro. That shit crazy, man.
Man, another one, legend we lost for real.
Yeah, we got next.
Mo 3.
Oh,
yeah, so y'all know I always bring up Mo 3 in every episode,
every
man.
Episode.
That nigga like he, man.
So what you so I know the fans, for our fans, we know we got a lot of them, but for our fans that probably want to know, what do us at the table think that happened in the situation? Because then you know a lot of people blaming BZ and shit. And
me personally, I think it was set up. You know what I'm saying? I think it was a hit. And BZ really set the hit up on my dog straight up because it was too much tension. It was way too much tension. Niggas hated Mo 3. I'm good for nobody saying. Niggas hated Mo 3 with their guts, dog. Straight up. Like, and it showed, like, he ain't get a lot of radio play. He couldn't get no breakthrough until the nigga met Boosie. That's when he really got his breakthrough, for real.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Boosie gave him his whole little, his push and shove. Whatever you want to call it, Boosie gave him that straight up. You know what I'm saying? But on BG's side, BG didn't have nobody really back him up like that. He came out on his own. Mainstream. Well, he do got that mainstream sound. He do got that mainstream tone. You know what I'm saying?
That's the only thing that
I
wonder.
He do use the right tones in his music,
that's
too.
The only thing why I wonder, because I'm like, that. Damn. Both of these, it ain't like.
He came out with his own little swag, too.
It ain't like one of these niggas ain't, it's like under the bus. Both of them is mainstream successful. Like.
Mo 3 just.
He was on his way.
He was on his way to be mainstream. He wasn't full mainstream.
He ain't get there all the
way. Nah. But Boosie,
he
didn't even get a chance to release his debut album yet. That I'm aware of.
Yeah, he can, yeah, well. If he ain't do that, then he probably ain't meant. But yeah. But we talking about 700,000 people.
Yeah, but that's go to the record label with that. They like, yeah, doesn't
700,000?
Yeah, them numbers, but them good numbers, but
hey, we would love 700,000.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Shoot, we gonna get there.
I love 10,000.
But see, Yellow Beezy is more versatile, and he more industry too. And Mo 3, he was tapping all that gangster, and even when he's singing some gangster shit.
Yeah. But he do got some shit for the ladies too, though.
He was definitely a GOAT, because especially when he dropped that Black Corona, like I was on the Mo 3 a little bit, this and that. When I heard that Black Corona, I'm like, man.
Y'all need to go look up Osama versus Mo 3. That right there, it give you both sides of him. Period. Cause you're gonna hear Gemini for it, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
And he got the Osama side, though, and then he got that. The Mo 3 side. The Mo 3 side is the cool, relaxed. That's where you get the ladies singing, the singing songs, and one of. But then you got Osama. That's the rapping gangster, killing, shooting, robbing, all that.
Right. So that's why he used to have an Osama chain.
Yeah.
But see, no disrespect to nobody, but you know a lot of people try to say he tried to impersonate Dex Osama with the Osama, you know, when he first came out, not recently, none of that.
He was going more of the Taliban Osama. That was his lane. I don't know where they got the Dex Osama thing from.
Only because they both big.
Who the fuck is Dex Osama?
Dex Osama from Detroit. The reason I got death on is Chopper nigga. Chopper boys.
He like the young Biggie of Detroit.
Yeah, he was probably another like a King Von or somebody for Detroit. You know what I'm saying?
Mo 3, he was coming straight from the Taliban. Like, he was letting you know, like that was my whole thing. I wanted to be the Taliban, the one the most hated. Like, and that's what it showed in the industry, for real. Except on Boosie, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know, but that was a real good dude, man. Shit, I felt like he didn't get to reach his peak yet. He was right there. Right there, dog.
I don't think Yellow Beezy had nothing to do with it, though.
You don't?
Understand. Mm-hmm. I feel like...
But...
go ahead, bro.
But it definitely was a setup.
If I'm not mistaken, I think they were saying the nigga was Yellow Beezy cousin.
What was it? Was it Mo 3? Yeah, you know, it was Yellow B and his boy's Jump Mo 3 manager.
Yeah.
You know, so ain't no telling. All that shit could have been had ties. But
and them boys was paying the promoter double to take Mo 3 off the shows and shit.
Money was a little bit longer at the time.
Yeah. Yeah, that was on my nigga 3 bad, bro. And I slide for 3, bro. I swear to God, I slide for 3. I don't give a fuck because he was blood or whatever he was. I slide RP for 3.
We're going to put a little, just probably a little bit of Black Corona in there. Here go the little cover of the Black Corona. And this little clip of the little Black Corona right now.
What's another hip hop death that touched y'all, man?
Let's go to King Von, man. How that shit? Because we gotta.
I felt like I lost my gangsta ass,
man. Because we gotta really understand that we all lost our homie from the streets that was a shooter or whatever. The nigga beat a murderer, came home, all that good shit.
The nigga beat
murderers
and came home.
You know what I'm saying? So, in the sense of me saying, I feel like, man, how they keep saying, like, he wasn't on his toes and shit that day. I don't know if God willing, you know what I mean? He just wanted his son. But, man, to not die in a city that is so treacherous and you got so much smoke in, you know what I'm saying? To be away from that, I feel like maybe that's why he even got a little leisure. Cause he like,
he got comfortable, man. Like, I'm not in
like damn, scene. Like I'm about to be with Dirk. Like, you get what I'm saying? Like, he about to be at the level Dirk was starting at. You get what I'm saying? Like, the Dirk we first got to do with the Bang Bros and just, shit like that.
And that first thing, though, he was only out a year.
That's what I'm saying. So
a year.
And then when you moving like how he moving, I can still. Like, y'all got this nigga brought 100,000 back to the hood, split it at the table with the homies.
With not men, the females and the niggas,
all man. The homies,
everybody got
all chains for the homies. So we talking about a real like Chicago and customized street legend, shit, all that shit.
And he was on that bitch, and I liked how he was on B-Roy that bitch. Like, oh, what's now? Already got their money. They already got theirs.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
So he was giving. It wasn't just everybody in the video. Yeah, everybody was getting broke off.
Everybody, And he was a smart nigga because he kept track of everything.
And motherfuckers who wasn't even there, he was like, here, look, you go spread it up between you and them over there. You know what I'm saying? You feel me? Like, make sure they get the cut too,
man. Yeah, niggas know what's up, man. I can't understand. It's hard, like, nobody ever questioned God and not supposed to, but it's hard to be like, Dub died, then Von died, and it wasn't even like a boom, boom, like, you see what I'm saying? And to be honest, we all thinking in the mind frame, it's supposed to be it. He got him, so now they going to get him. Yeah. You feel me? They squad done got they big homies, so now they squad got to go get the man. Yeah, like, it never even happened that way, dude. That shit crazy as fuck.
See, what King Von messed up?
Duck should have had a better gun.
We gonna get to Duck.
No, I got Duck on the list. His girl shot.
I got Duck on the list, though. We gonna get to Duck.
Then his shit jammed up.
But
his shit jammed. Then his shit jammed.
I don't know.
Man.
We gonna get to Duck, though. But King Von, see where he messed up at. I don't want to say he ain't got no OGs, but somebody was supposed to let him know. Like, you in the industry now. Can't be trying to fight and do all
that. That don't exist in the Chicago.
Yeah.
OGs don't exist down there.
OGs ain't.
That don't exist.
They're hooping.
He became the OG once he start
breaking bread.
You feel what I'm saying? That's what them young niggas love down there. It ain't no.
He became his project.
But see, Dirk could have said something.
But they can't move together. They had that case to where they can't even be around each other.
Look, little bro. I'm fighting and fuck that. You know, we gonna get that nigga. Don't worry about it. We gonna get that nigga, but don't be out here doing all that fighting.
Bro, yeah, talking
to
a nigga.
That was his image too, though.
All this shit.
That was his image. So
all this shit was supposed to be over. Young boy, baby mama, being in the club. I mean, being at the studio with Von. That has no ties to Rondo. We got to remember, Young Boy signed Rondo. They not even from the same city.
Yeah.
So Rondo is another young nigga that love Young Boy like all these other young niggas do, and done got the chance to be with him. So now you in something that really pertain around him. If that's what it wasn't your chick, it wasn't your baby mama, you were. So then when y'all got word, because what happened was, once the picture came out, Rondo got to talking on Twitter and shit, Instagram, like, oh yeah, niggas on niggas, bitches and all that. Oh, Von, like, oh, when we catch him, I'ma treat him like a baby. I'm a grown man, walk him. So that's all what happened.
Shit, the rat had Chief Keef baby on the video when he was talking shit about the old block niggas. And she got up with the dog, like, oh, hell no.
And then like you said, his image being his image, is like, niggas can't really let that type shit fly. I guess being where he from and being how he move, but I don't know, man. V-Roy, he just kind of, I don't know. I'm fucked up about that one because that was kind of a.
Why he ain't have no good?
Think no police on him?
Somebody with him should have had a gun.
They did. They was all in the car. All the guns were in the car because they was walking into the club. So
actually, he took off running out the truck.
Walking
and they didn't know what he was doing, so they expected, hey, well, I'm going to the club.
Yeah, because when we pull up to the scene, every time scene, when we pull up, everybody put the guns up because we know we can't go in with them. So we getting ready to go in.
Didn't nigga that shot him, ran and got the gun out of the car?
No. Yeah. He was already over there and he came around from the car.
Who? Or Lil Tim?
Yeah.
He said Lil Tim jumped out the driver's seat. Bam.
Oh, he was already in.
He was in. It was a white car parked right here. They got the fighting right around the white car. By the time they
hit the back, behind the car.
By the time they got to the back where the lights was at, Tim done jumped out. Boom, boom. So he was in the car.
He was sitting in the car waiting, doing his motherfucking job.
Because look, Quando pulled up in a motherfucking Porsche or something. They said he pulled up in a nice ass little car. That's why in the video y'all seen walking to the car that Tim was in. They didn't even know that car even existed. They thinking that bitch parked. Tim had already been there waiting on Rondo to pull up.
He was standing in front of a truck. Like he was talking to somebody in the truck.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Because Tim was in that white truck. Tim was in that Ford Explorer, a regular civilian car. Quando pull up with a driver in a red like Porsche or something. They said a red vet or a red Porsche or something. That's when he pop out and go holler at Tim. He know who in the area just cause Von Boy just sinked him. Now Von Boy just sinked him. He know Von Boy just sinked him. He going to holler at Tim. Von Boy going to holler at Von. Hey, you know Boy in the area. That's when he pop out the car. That's when he already had a shooter car. The shooter car is already there. This bitch been here before he even got here. This bitch parked. Yeah, when. Track even said it. Track is Von Manager. He even said it like we didn't even know nobody was even in that car. We didn't even know that nobody. They didn't even know that car was right there. Type shit. Cause that bitch a civilian car. Y'all so used to moving with money.
No disrespect, but that's the way
it go.
That's the way, and that's the way it should have been happening. No disrespect to Nipsey. That's how I feel about his situation. It should have been some niggas sitting in a car or something away. He ain't had to have a gun, his people, but somebody. Which is, when he said something to that dude, they should have walked up. Because he should have had, I know you in your hood, you feel like you don't supposed to have security in your hood, but you got to have somebody around you for protection. Because the way life going right now, it don't matter. Legends die every day. I don't care how famous you is, how important you is.
Me personally, if I was going to have tax bracket, why are these guns wrong for me? I'm not being nowhere where I feel like my life's gonna be filled with
money.
But I ain't gonna be in no vicinity where I'm worried about a motherfucker
on the ground. I don't wanna kidnap.
Big dog, if you nip, that's cap all the way because you still on Slauson Street. So you can't not feel like you gonna not be in an area where it's not gonna happen. Cause if you own Slauson Street,
yeah, that's why I said
period.
If I'm in that tax bracket, I'm not gonna be in no area where I know I'm in some type of
somebody wanna kidnap you and hold you for ransom.
You ain't gonna be able to get to me because my house like Boosie's or like Rick Ross.
You gotta go somewhere. You ain't gonna be in a house.
But see,
when niggas,
I can move around, but I'm not gonna be moving to where I'm riding down Door Street, or I'm riding down Harley. You're not gonna catch me just sliding down Harley.
But if they planning to do something to you, they waiting and paying attention to all your moves. If they planning to rob you, if they planning to do this.
Yeah, but who say I'm?
But I understand.
You ain't something just gonna be able. You gonna have to move how I move to the point to where you gonna be flying when I'm flying. You gonna be private jetting when I'm private jetting. You gonna be.
They ain't gotta do that. All they gotta do is sit on 2-3 spots that you go to. And that's it. They sit on that bitch.
But that's the thing though. If I'm in a different type of bracket, cause you not even go nowhere I'm even at to be able to think about, let me go sit at LAX. Cause Mook comes this motherfucker every other Thursday.
They don't even pull up to LAX.
No, they don't wanna sit at LAX. They wanna go sit at your baby mama house, your kid's house. Yeah. You know? Some action.
That shit ain't even supposed to be around though.
You ain't even gonna be able to know my baby mama stay. You ain't gonna know my kids stay.
That shit ain't supposed to be around. That shit gonna be. You is not supposed to stay off Lewis and Lasky.
You not my baby
mama. You crazy the motherfucker.
You ain't even.
It's too busy.
You not even finna know. You not even finna know my brother baby mama stay at. If I'm in that tax bracket, you not even know my brother baby mama stay at. Because I got everybody gone. I got everybody gone. It ain't no reason for.
That's how you got it.
Yeah, I ain't finna have no type of way to where you feel like you don't have some type of leverage to where I feel like I'm in danger. I'm not finna be having $70 million and feel like my life is in danger at no point in a given time. Period. Like, I don't give a fuck if I'm in a hotel by myself in the middle of.
So you ain't gonna rock jury then. But see me, I'm gonna carry a gun regardless. I ain't about to.
No, once I get such a money, what are you?
I ain't even
buying jewelry shit no more because my money's so long.
I want to go out, you know, put on your roadie or put your shits on. Then after you touch that money, you ain't gonna give a fuck about none of that.
I don't even go out now.
To be honest with me, I think even if I still had security, I'm keeping me a pipe on me. I don't got no felonies right now in you. I mean, God forbid, I ain't gonna have none.
I'm saying,
even if I'm 50 Cent right now, I'm not even saying what he do, all this trolling or what nothing. I'm just saying, if I'm the nigga who used to own vitamin water, I got a pistol in my pocket. This is the only reason why. Because I made bulletproof. My shit, get rich or die trying. I done got shot 9 times already. I ain't moving. Man, look, I get what you saying, Mook. It's helicopter here. Helicopter, a nigga gonna have to get a rocket launcher to get you, period. But you still might have to keep guns on that helicopter with you to shoot down if that rocket coming.
Man,
you see what I'm saying?
Yeah,
just to be on the safe side.
Yeah, but this is my thing. If I'm moving all the negative shit out of my life, period.
Right,
I'm not even thinking about having a gun to even shoot that motherfucker at all.
Right.
I got a gun just because I collect them because old man Willis down the street. He done got me into the shit. That's the only reason why I got a gun. It's not never to be, let me keep this motherfucker by the bed because it's a possibility me living in this $30 million mansion that a motherfucker finna creep through these woods and creep through my cameras and make his way to my room so I can shoot a nigga.
Motherfucker, officer done been on the force 30-something years and ain't shot his gun. He ain't looking to kill nobody or nothing. When he go home, that bitch under the pillow, under his bed next to, he got a shotgun and everything. And he don't even live in a $30 million. He might stay on Stickney and Woodward.
I can't talk about that.
But at the same time,
it's
going to be your mental.
No.
Hey, look, all I'm going to say is, you don't think the gang got no pistols around him?
That's different.
Gang. He the nip for the bloods. He ain't. He ain't the nip for the bloods.
Yeah, and no. Because
gang ain't probably got no felonies either.
Yeah, he got a couple of it.
You think gang got some felonies?
He probably got a clear.
I don't even know about him being in jail.
No, I don't know about him doing no time.
I don't know about him being in jail.
Yeah, I don't know about him.
And I followed up on a little bit. I was into him back in the day.
Well, misdemeanors. That still stop you from getting a pistol, having a pistol.
Not for no gun license. You need a felony to stop you from getting your gun license. I got a misdemeanor.
Domestic violence ain't a felony, though. Assault. If you got anything that's a violent, like a fighting.
But if you wasn't convicted of it. Then it ain't. You know what I'm saying? If you wasn't convicted of it, he might have been going to court for it or something, but he wasn't convicted.
We don't even know. Well, now due to the nip situation, I would say game have a gun on him.
So you don't think before that he don't have? Wait, I know exactly before that because I remember watching a documentary of game. He was hooping. Yeah. And he had his pistol on him while he was hooping.
Right.
But he could have been doing that just for the documentary, but he was talking about
I know that game been having pistols on him because Vlad was his cameraman before he was Vlad TV. And Vlad used to say, game and them used to have so many pistols and shit, that's why he stopped being a cameraman because it was too much gang shit. Niggas keep pointing pistols at the camera and shit. He ain't with all that. Yeah. Like, you know what I'm saying? So he turned into a vlogger type shit, but... He done been in the street with Game in the street, nigga, with when they shooting in with the camera type shit.
I ain't know that about that.
Yeah, they got a whole doc. Matter of fact, it's Game first album. It's like Hell something Game shit. It's Vlad on the front cover, nigga, with a hat tipped to the back, nigga, white boy, nigga, on this side. Game in the middle, Vlad on this side, somebody else on that side. Twice today on camera.
Yeah, twice on camera, but all day in person. Man, it's crazy.
Yeah, but who is on Will on the Vaughn? Yeah, man, RIP, we ain't mean to miss out on you, man. RIP, King Vaughn, we kind of went sidetracked, it, man. That situation could have went a little bit better. Shit.
Who was
it? We got Duck. We got Duck. Yeah.
I ain't fuck with Duck. I ain't really fuck with Duck either,
but... Do y'all think he died because of the Dead Bitches song, or do y'all think he was just all the way around?
He died
because
he had the wrong gun.
I think he died because some street shit.
Yeah, this is street nigga shit all the way
around. I think he died because he had the wrong gun. It looked like a high point to me.
Don't do him like that.
Don't do, yeah.
It looked like it was a straight high point to me, though. I don't know. I asked when I get there. But yeah, he had the wrong gun.
Man, don't go too crazy. Duck Mama, she'll be in the comments real quick.
And his lady was busting though. That's loyalty, ain't it? Ain't that loyalty because she ain't take off running.
But did she die too?
No.
They ain't finish the job.
She got shot though.
They ain't finish the job.
I don't know if she got shot.
That wasn't part of the job though with that.
Shit, bitch, if you busting, you part of it now.
No.
We gonna leave your dumb ass.
She might bust.
Look, ain't we from Chirac? Y'all hoes got guns all the time. Bitch, get the fuck on with that shit. Get fuck on with that bitch. That pinner ass gun, like you just said.
That's crazy.
Girl probably had a high point. Get the fuck on with that pinner ass gun. We blew him. That's all we wanted. We ain't worried about that pinner ass gun you shooting. I mean, it's loyalty though. But they ain't shooting for her.
Yeah, right.
Bitch, if you don't get out the way, you gon' die.
They got him in the suburbs.
Bitch, if you don't get out the way, you go down.
They call him like a downtown.
Him and his girl, yeah. Subs. The subway, they was shopping. They was shopping.
Well, yeah, I guess y'all do consider that a sub. But y'all always have the suburbs. That shit downtown in the city to me.
No, they weren't in the city, though. They was, I forgot because they was right outside of, or coming from a store. It was a certain store. I can't remember the name. I want to get the line.
Yeah.
I think it was outside the Louis store for real.
That's what I was thinking.
Duck, I ain't really fuck with your music, bruh. RIP to you. I know your mom be on YouTube with it, you know what I mean, going on with your story and shit like that. My Dukes, I don't really like how you get on dirt for real, but you know that's between y'all, you know what I'm saying?
I hope she got a good gun too.
You know, Next subject, we be rolling to. This is no cap table though. But yeah, we gonna keep it rolling because it's no disrespect. We might have to move to Chicago for a good time to shoot something, man. Look, no disrespect.
I done been to Chicago. Ain't no big homies, so who gonna check in with?
That's mom.
when is we about to get on? Can we check something else too? Y'all got something else?
Oh, I'll check it with her if she got a high point like him.
No.
Fuck it, let's get on. We kind of got on Pop Smoke, but the little Pop Smoke situation since he didn't check in and all that shit.
Whoa.
I fuck with Pop, you know what I'm saying? Pop definitely was he was definitely kind of a one-on-one type nigga. I ain't never really seen.
And he was lacking too much.
You say he was lacking too much?
Yeah. They posting addresses all on the gram. He on the crib niggas. The GS9 and the Wu niggas.
But see, I think Pop was only like 19, 20.
Yeah,
all these niggas are like, man.
Nigga look about 30, though. Voice about 30.
Yeah.
But
I thought it was 50-something. I ain't gonna lie.
Yeah, that nigga younger than all of us at this table.
Man.
Crazy.
So, y'all just felt like he should have been moving better with the lap?
Tupac was even young, too. Shit. He was 25 when he died.
Yeah.
But yeah.
But we wasn't born at that time, so he all older than us. He just died at 25, but yeah. The nigga was born in, we talk about a nigga that was born in 2000. He's younger than us.
Damn!
You see what I'm saying?
Born in 2000.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah!
You see what I'm saying?
Damn!
If I can still, when I start remembering the year, I know a nigga young, you feel me? Because I was born in 99. No, 98. I was born in 98.
Man, I remember motherfuckers saying the world was going to end in 2000, bro. I was probably like a second grade, maybe. Second or third grade. Nigga, I'm talking about all the little kids crying, nigga. The teacher crying, the world going to end.
Nigga would have told me that. I'd have been like, more sippy cup, please. I'm two. I ain't sure on none of that. Man. Sippy cup, please.
Hey, I'm in class like, hey, when do you think the world about to end? Bitch, I'm just going to go to sleep and wake up. It's going to be another day.
Man.
They really crying that it's about to be the world, and I'm like, well,
I ain't gonna lie, 2012 scared the shit out of me though when they said the world's gonna end in 2012, but then they came out with the movie 2012 and shit. I'm like, man, yo,
I ain't never been scared of the world going in, dog. It's just like this bitch going in, it just hurt the fuck up because this shit around here is crazy than a motherfucker.
No, but see, this what I mean. This what I
like, how this motherfucker supposed to end?
Right. That's my thing. This bitch was supposed to blow up.
My granny told me a story about how it's supposed to end in the Bible. I don't want to quote it because I don't want to get it wrong and I get a whole bunch of, you know what I'm saying, slack. But one thing I can say is I feel like people say the world is going to end because they don't understand, or they do understand, but their minds don't take them times and things is going to change. So for instance, my granny is 85. I don't want to get it wrong. She 80 something. So, in her mind, the world is coming to an end because of the shit she's seeing. Motherfuckers is gay. God don't like gays. This and that. You know what I mean? Like, what's in the Bible? I'm not, no disrespect, but I'm just saying, like, different shit like that, that she feel like the world would have never had growing up. You see what I'm saying? So, that's why people sort of feel like the world. So, it's just like, if we get in 2025, I mean, like, 2031 or whatever, fuck. Being old as fuck, we might feel like
the world
gonna end because cars starting to fly and shit like that. And when we was young, motherfucker tell, hey, when cars start to fly, this bitch gone. Like, you see what I'm saying?
And so, how many niggas wrote the Bible?
I don't know.
12 niggas, didn't it?
The
Bible been rewritten so many ways. You got the King James Version. You got, who other version you got? You got the Old Testament, the New Testament.
So what you trying to say? I can come out with a version if I want to?
Hell yeah, you can. You could call it the 2021 version. The 2020 version.
I want to put my name in my shit like James. Ain't it? No, I ain't gonna. I'm just bullshit.
I believe anybody can write the Bible because it's all about what you, the knowledge, a motherfucker, what they heard, the word of mouth. Right? That's all the Bible is, the word of mouth. Is what a whole bunch of people thought, put it in the Bible. I'm releasing this day. I'm releasing this time, I'm rewrite that one by four. Man. I'm gonna even match it for my great. Is the Old Testament the new first Bible? No, it ain't the first Bible.
I feel like the Bible could have been made by a person who God gave that one wisdom to write that. Like, if
you... So it was made by a bunch of pastors?
No, I'm not even a pastor. What I'm saying, I'm talking about time, where it go. If, if you know how to do something very well, like how you know how to do gold very well, that's your gift. That's almost the God-given gift to you. That's probably a gift that somebody else got to write that motherfucker and probably got pushed down the line. And
okay, but how many people at that time thought that they had that gift to write it, and which one got picked to be a better version?
Have you ever read one?
What, Bible?
Yeah. I haven't
read the Bible full through, but I have read like certain parts of the Bible.
Only
I read the Quran a lot.
Only parts I read of the Bible was the ones that they said fall on the church.
I barely read those. But I have read just open it one time and just. But I'm gonna be honest, it's hard to understand it.
That's what I tell my granny all the time. She tell me to read it all the time.
That's what the James one was for, right? I thought that one was for so it can write it so we can understand it better. That's what I thought that one was for.
It could be. I'm not for sure. Yeah.
I ain't too sure.
I'm not for sure.
Even when it's wrote to be better, I still don't understand it. I'm like.
Gotta know Shakespeare. It's like, no. Let me go ahead. Let's talk about something else, man.
But no disrespect, you know, to no religions and not out there like that. I'm just saying, like, I don't know. I just don't understand some things. Somebody need to break it down to me. And I'm tired of pastors always giving me the same speech, too. So I want the pastor, like, assistant to tell me some shit. That's what we'll be doing.
You said the pastor assistant?
Yeah.
Not bad. I'm not with the Bible, bro. At your church, whatever church you want to be at.
That's a business church.
Hey, what we do feel like is if we can get somebody who actually knows the Bible to come in and explain it to us better, we might have a different outlook on it.
And please do not get mad at me because I like joking and saying some things. Don't get offended.
Yeah, we all know, joke at this table.
It's called a no cap table, so I'm not finna hold back.
Yeah, definitely.
But I will respect you.
Definitely. What's the next thing, yo? We touched on the rapper's death. We got a couple. Can think of any other rapper. I got one rapper that people probably don't know about. Y'all ever heard of EBE Bands? No. White Boy?
Nope.
He's from Chicago. He used to be with the GMJ. I don't want to get a mistake or whatever. But long story short, he got kidnapped and they end up finding his body at an abandoned house, and the white dude who was in on it, his car was parked at his house, and I guess he held the body from the police or whatever. They sentenced that nigga to like 90 days in jail or some shit like that.
That killed the rapper?
Swear to God. It was something short, like, it might have been like 2 days and like in 3 years probation or something. It was something short. The nigga that killed EB, the nigga that had something to do that killed EB
and
Ben.
Both of the white.
I think so. I'm not for sure. I don't want to get a mistake, but, because I was up on dude. Matter of fact, I swear to God, this is so crazy that, I follow him on Instagram. And then one day his manager got on his Instagram and was posting shit like he missing and shit. But I'm thinking they playing. Like, I'm thinking this some real fake fraud. Somebody that got into an Instagram account.
Some fame type shit.
This shit done went on for 3-4 months. I'm like, what? Or it might have been weeks. I'm like, what the fuck? He's still missing? Like, he missing. Because he used to be an active ass white boy on Instagram. I ain't gonna lie. That's why I followed him. Because he was like active. I'm talking about he had SRTs and he drinking lean and he really in the streets. So it was like a vibe shit.
Okay.
Man. Dude that killed him ended up getting some baby food, bro. For real.
Damn.
I ain't heard about him, bro. That crazy right
there. Yeah, I'm about to look for sure.
Yeah, that shit crazy as hell, man. Did we talk about the
Hey, you know, I don't know if y'all really in tune with Buddy like that, but Mozzie. He was Kevin Gates artist.
Now, you talking about Mozzie from East Oakland?
No. It was another one. It was B.
That's
my dog.
He came out, if I'm not mistaken, I think he came out a little bit after him, but he was Kevin Gates artist, though. He had, okay, boom. First time nigga get hit up in a Waffle House. Nigga live. He got shot like him. They were like, don't get wrong, 4 to 6 times inside a Waffle House. Boom. Then the second time they catch nigga come out the pizza spot late night on some just crazy shit. Smoke nigga outside the pizza spot. But He was Kevin Gates artist though, man. I was about, well, he really ain't got too much music. He really wasn't known too much for music. He was just one of them gangsta ass niggas from Atlanta, though. That's all he really was, though. Like a gangsta ass nigga from Atlanta would be calling him Kevin Gates. He had like two or three tracks.
Man. Yeah. I know a gangsta ass nigga from Atlanta that ended up dying, and you know what I mean, RIP to that young man, young Lil Marlo, man. Yeah, Lil Marlo was the man.
Yeah, that
man.
Shit right there was wicked.
I ain't gonna lie, I ain't gonna say my homie name because he got some shit going on up in upstate, but I know one of my homies, man. He said when he spent time out there in Atlanta, he was out there in Marlo and them hood, and Marlo was like one of his homies that was actually cool, like, hey, I'ma fuck with you on some shit, and you know what I mean, just like I'ma show you around type shit. He said they ended up getting cool, doing a lot of, we ain't gonna say, but you know what I mean? He said Marlo was a cool dude, and this was before Marlo even died. This was before I even knew who he was. Like, he told me about Marlo. He like, you know about a nigga named Lil Marlo that be with Lil Baby? I'm like, nah, not for real. Get to showing me pictures of shit. And then once I, like, really get hit to him, I'm like, damn, this who dude, this who you cuz talking about. But I still wasn't on top of him. I wish I would've got more hit to him, because I heard he was a hell of a guy. But I think his shit got shot up, what, 100 times or some shit? He was in the car?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Shot like 100 times?
I ain't heard to that.
Yeah, that was a baby boy.
Oh, right, since we talking about baby. Okay, look. We talked about the All-Star shit last episode. But I forgot to say, did we not know? You dropped it again.
Three times.
Did we not notice that Lil Baby and Quavo was on different teams? Quavo had he had the white boy on the team. Jack Harlow. He had Jack Harlow on his team, and it was Lil Baby and Chainz. Yeah. And then look, Quavo go up for a layup. This one the game, damn near first start. Boom. Quavo go for a layup. He missed. And foul shot. He bumped Baby. They don't even look at each other. He bumped Baby. Then go back to the line and get the shooting. That's the first thing I noticed. I cut off the gas. I said, oh, I can't wait till I get to the podcast. I got to tell the homies.
Yeah, yeah.
But I'm like,
are you telling they got some?
Remember I told you. Remember I was saying on the other episode, like, how niggas was, they wasn't salty, but how, like, Baby got a bunch of shine, and then some shit ended up going down with a lawyer to where they end up suing QC and shit. So,
I remember you were saying,
my whole thing is this. How are we supposed to be on the same label, but we ain't even on the same basketball team on this movie shit? This some star shit.
I thought Baby went on a label. I just thought,
No, he QC.
I thought QC was managing him.
He QC.
So he don't pay for all his shit?
He still probably pay for it all, but he get it on the back end. Because it's like this. If I pay for it now, when they send the check, I need everything. Y'all don't get no cut. You see what I'm saying? So it's like either way it go. You know, it really don't make no. Never mind.
Yeah, I was watching it. I think he was on Ellen or some shit talking that shit. Look.
Yeah.
But that's one thing that I had to touch on, because I don't even think that, I know y'all ain't see it, but we ain't even say it last episode, and it kind of puzzled me. Like, damn, ain't nobody. Ain't no other media sites talk about that. So we the first one to kind of talk about that.
Right.
But I think if it was a bump that he was fucking with him on, they'd at least looked at each other. Like, nigga, watch out. Like, you know what I mean? Like on some playing shit or whatever shit.
Yeah,
It was more of a fuck this nigga. Like,
tension.
Like,
Like you can feel the tension.
Yeah. I felt it on the TV. I'm like, damn. Went back and rewind. Like, hold on, though. For real. I wanted to make sure I wasn't tripping, because I wanted to say it when I got here. Like, man, that shit was crazy.
Lil Baby and Quavo. Who y'all think will win the one-on-one fight?
I wouldn't even put that on nobody.
Ah, Quavo.
Hey, I ain't even
gonna. Lil Baby, can you play basketball?
I was just about to say, the way he showed me his athletic skills,
so he might
that nigga better pick up a strap.
No. The baby,
maybe my dog gonna fuck with
the baby carrying the strap for self.
The way
he carrying the strap for self.
The way that nigga was shooting the jumpers.
Remember that one picture of him? He had.
When he was taking the picture with George Floyd's daughter.
Hoodie.
George Floyd's daughter.
And he was with somebody else too. He was with an older rapper nigga.
Oh, Bun B, I think it was.
That's what I thought.
He was in Houston or some shit.
My stupid ass. R.I.P. to Pimp C. I was about to say, I think it was Pimp C, but.
Yeah, he was with Bun. The Bun one.
So, best believe he keep a strap because nigga like me.
He fuck with you, baby.
My size coming and shake baby up. This boy gonna shake all this jewelry off him real quick. Yeah, everything he going. Light is gonna shake between his eyes.
Yeah, man. So, we about to go ahead and wrap it up. I know y'all love seeing us and we love seeing y'all, but we got to keep the content for the next episode. But before we wrap it up, we're going to let D do his quick drinker for a thinker type thing today. And then we're going to, you know what I mean, be out of there.
Baby Strip Club.
Ooh.
Baby
Strip Club.
Gotta be quick.
The old Palms in Toledo.
Shot.
Mine, y'all gotta take me because I ain't never been.
Damn, you ain't never been?
I'm 22, I ain't never been.
You never? Well, I was a strip club at 15, dog. So you tell me you ain't never been to a strip club?
Closest I probably deja vu's and I didn't get in the inside. I was still young as fuck. And by the time I got old enough, I ain't care for it. Like, you know what I mean? Like, man. I cared, but I didn't really care for it.
Yeah. I mean, you missed the era of strip club then, because right now you're just going to walk into a bunch of C-sections.
Shit, y'all about to go to,
I ain't going.
We ain't going to see money shit. No.
Nah, not yet.
What's your favorite, nigga? What's your favorite strip club?
My favorite strip club, I ain't been there in years. I used to go there when I was younger. My brother used to take me Crazy Horse in Detroit.
That's where Dex got killed at, Famous Dex. That's where Famous Dex got killed.
Oh, he did too?
Yeah,
I mean, not famous Dex. Dex Osama. Dex Osama.
Dex, though.
Yeah, man, but y'all know what it is, man. It's a no cap table talk podcast, man.
Yes, sir.
It's your host, CEO Sim.
OG Moot.
And your boy, Willie D.
And you know it's the no cap. We out, man.
I want you to like, subscribe, comment, share. Man, tune in with us, man. Stop playing, man. Up these views one time for us, man.
Let's go.
Come get some of this merch, man.
Up, man.
Come on, man. We love y'all.
Hey, we got something special for y'all, too, so please stay tuned, man. We out.